Most people today use PPC software to manage their bids. They set a set of rules and they have the software go in there and change their bids based on a set of rules. What I've been seeing lately is with all of the out of stocks people are having, the inventory limits and the seasonality of holidays like Mother's Day and Easter and stuff like that, your bids are going to change based off of that. And if those bids are being changed too much, especially, you know, when they're out of stock, or if you forget to change them when they're out of stock, and or you want to push super aggressively for a keyword at the top of the page, you want to have a higher ACOS, the softwares are changing stuff too much. And I've had a couple people come to me and say, listen, you know, this is not what I signed up for. So you need to remember that if you do have those, just make sure you have enough rules in place. Make sure you know what's happening either with someone at the software company or a PPC manager that's watching over that. But after that rant, I'm going to show you guys the simplest way to change your bids with bulk uploads. So if you have some high ACOS or stuff is happening and you want to change a bunch of bids at once, this is the easiest way to do it. Now, every time I open up a bulk upload, you guys will see that I put filters at the very top, okay? So I put filters at the very top. Since we are changing bids here, all I want to look at is keyword and product targeting. Keyword and product targeting. You can do ad group, but that if you change that, you know, that would change the bid for everything in the ad group, which isn't the best way to do it. So let's look at keyword and product targeting, which is ASIN targeting. Now, there's two things you should look at when you want to change bids. There is, I've just sort clicks largest to smallest. So this is all of our data, right? We have all of our big keywords, 443 clicks, 20% ACOS. These are all of our good ones, right? Usually, if I'm doing this in a pinch, what I'll do is I'll come here, I'll sort clicks largest to smallest, and then I'll sort ACOS largest to smallest as well. So what this shows me is now I have all of my high ACOS words that I want to, that are probably causing me issues. And there's not a bunch in here. This is a pretty optimized account, but I want to show you guys some examples here. So what I'm actually going to do, and this is another tip, I'm going to start repeating myself here. If you're scared of bulk uploads, and let's say we want to change everything that's over 70% ACOS, okay? The opposite end of this is you would go clicks largest to smallest, and then sales smallest to largest. So you can get clicks, things are getting clicks and no sales, and you can lower those bids. But let's do everything over 70% ACOS. All I'm gonna do is just copy these and paste them, okay? And then you copy your header and you paste that in here. So now you just have the ones you wanna change. So you can delete these sheets, and let me just make sure that I can delete this because I have messed up before. So okay, delete these sheets. Right, you can delete sponsored brands. We're not messing with these. Let's not worry about them. We just want to update our bids for sponsored products, and we're almost there. Now, this is the thing. So, now I can't give away all my secrets, but if you know someone who's good with Excel, or you have, this is where you can do a simple Excel rule book, where if you say if ACOS is over 100%. And if clicks are larger than 20, then lower bid by 20%, or let's say 50%. And then you say you do another window. So think of this is your custom rule set that you can input. Say if ACOS is between 80 and 100 and clicks are more than 20, then lower bid by 20%. If ACOS is between 70 and 80, and clicks are more than 20, lower bid by 10%, okay? So you have windows. You don't just want to come in here and, you know, put 25-cent bids on everything. And one of the things I was saying there, and what a lot of people do, is they forget that filter. This keyword only has 8 clicks, and it has an order, and it's 95% ACOS. I'm not going to touch that. It's only got 8 clicks, right? You don't want to mess with that. So try to find someone, hire someone, do kind of an Excel rule book where you can say, you know, if it falls under these two things, lower it by this much. If it falls under this category, lower it by this much. Now, if you don't want to do that, you can. You can very much, and you don't have a lot of data, you can just come in here and say, okay, I want to lower this by 20%. So, right, you just times it by 0.8. 0.8 is 76 cents. Boom, you just lower that by 20%. Say you want to lower all of these by 20%, okay? Now, maybe you want to lower all of these by 10%, multiply by 0.9. But you say, what is going on with this one? Why is there no max bid there? So what happens here? This is when you set an ad group level bid and then never change it. If you set an ad group level bid of 75 cents, right? And you never give this, and this is actually loose match. So say you set your auto targeting to 75 cents, and then you never went in there and manually changed the loose match bid. It's going to default to whatever the ad group bid is. Okay? But this brings me to my next level of what you should do. Now, a good indicator and how to find, especially how to find these blank ones, is cost per click. So, don't know why they don't have cost per click in here, right? It doesn't make any sense. All you have to do, and let's just do it here, equals spend divided by clicks. Boom, I got my cost per click, okay? So, this is why, actually ignore what I just said with lowering the bids, because at this point, if you have placement stats and you have more advanced campaigns, my cost per click is $1.14, right? But my max bid is only 95 cents, so I must have some placement stats in there somewhere. So if you're just managing your account, you can go in there and look at that and say, okay, well, maybe I just want to lower my placement stats. But this is still fine, right? If I still lower this to 76 cents, my placement stats are still going to be in effect, and it's still going to lower the overall cost per click. But this gives you such a better picture. So for this one, where I don't know what the bid is, the cost per click there is 21 cents, okay? So that's a pretty good indicator. So it's kind of a placeholder, and it's not going to be perfect. So you can, I mean, we can look at all of these. We can see, so we can see the bids, and the cost per click is generally higher than the bids because there's a lot of placement stats going on. You probably won't have this, but still, guys, this is a very, very simple formula to follow to lower all of your bids. So what happens, you know, these ones don't have a value. So this one, what, it was 21 cents, right? So we want to lower it 10%. These are 43 and these are 93, okay? So we load all of our bids. Now, we paste values. Okay, we have all of those bids are lowered by 20 or 10%, whatever you want to do with them, okay? And then just make sure you delete these. The bulk file, when you upload it, has to be in the same exact format than when you downloaded it, okay? So I can't, again, I can't give away the advanced macro that we use because there's a lot that goes into it. But I hope this actually sheds some light on these windows you can look at. Look at the ACOS. Remember to look at keywords that have enough clicks. And it's a pretty simple formula. Say I download this again and these keywords are still super, super high. So I still want to download, or I still want to lower all of these by 20%, regardless of what they are. Boom. 20%. Done. Lower them all again. Paste in values. Delete this one, ready for upload. Okay? So it's pretty simple. Go in there, and even if you go in there and look at this, you know, you guys are going to be looking at it, like on actually looking at the keywords, looking at the ASIN targeting, you'll know maybe you do want to lower some of these to 10 cents and just get rid of them. Okay? But this is all you need to do. So I hope this helps. Don't go too crazy. I hope you guys are getting a little more efficient with bulk uploads. Remember, one step at a time when you're doing things like this.